Sonia Richards Ross 4x400, Claiborne Price 4x400 men's and women's shot put, and the men's and women's long jump to close out our very, very busy 4 days of programming. The men's 4x400, there is the meet record, Texas A&M, back in 2011, LSU all the way back in 2005. This is the University and College first section, South Plains, Wayland Baptist, Harvard, Western Texas. Guys has Scratch, Texas A&M Commerce, UT Arlington, Air Force, Wiley, and Virginia Tech. Athletes will stay in their lanes through the first three turns. Three-turn stagger underway, 4x400 meters.
The fastest qualifier yesterday, Texas A&M Commerce, 3:07.91. Only 2 seconds really separate all nine of these teams.
Jude Christian will start things out for Commerce. Rodney Aguirre May for Harvard. Demetrius Turner for Wayland Baptist. South Plains will start things off with Junior Charles, Kimori Shearman for Wiley. And Virginia Tech on the outside, Gregory Childs running the opening leg. Big stagger, so look to see who hands the baton first. Air Force Academy with Sedacy Walden there as well. Air Force Academy with a slight lead here as we're into the second leg.
Looks like Air Force followed by UT Arlington right now as they get ready to break for the inside. See how many take the direct line to the 200-meter mark.
Well, if this young man is for the Air Force, he's working on trajectories and going to be a pilot in the future, so he knows how to figure angles. Zachary Dickin running now for the Air Force Academy. Things as we thought, tightening up a little bit, UT Arlington getting there, and here comes Wiley, Siobhan Parks running a very nice second leg. Air Force still maintains the lead. This is Chip White, Marbeck Edgar running for Wiley.
And Arlington working way too hard trying to get in front, and Air Force holding him off. That takes a lot of energy for the athlete who's trying to pass.
Brendan Wallace on the outside, putting out all that effort for UT Arlington.
And a little demoralizing as well. You keep trying to pass, the guy won't let you by, and it hurts physically and it hurts mentally.
And you're running a further distance as well. Remember, it's 7 meters per lap, or lane, I should say, as you move out. So he's running 3.5, 4, 5 meters further than he needs to.
Virginia Tech back in contact. Here comes Wiley on the outside with Edgar. And there are going to be a full 4, 5, maybe even 6 teams very, very much in the running here as well. Wayland Baptist, Air Force, Wiley, Virginia Tech, UT Arlington now in the lead.
Everybody's full of run the first 200 meters.
That's Wayland Baptist now coming up on the outside. Texas A&M Commerce, excuse me, Air Force, Wiley, UT Arlington. Arlington holding off, Air Force trying to get back in. And here comes Wiley up on the outside, UT Arlington on the inside, David Slasher from UT Arlington, but it's going to be Wiley's Rajay Hamilton. And very close for second, Air Force might have gone in for second place.
Well, it was just as competitive as we expected based on the times that it took to get here from yesterday's qualifying in the morning, 3:07.15. So they ran faster today than they did yesterday. But 4 or 5 teams in contention with 100 meters to go, that's the way you like to see it.
Yeah, that was really interesting, Dwight, at the last baton exchange. There were half a dozen teams that were still very much in contention. A little mosh pit right here at the start-finish line.
And no disaster, luckily. Pretty clean exchanges considering how many people were there. This is where it comes down to. Ray J just turned it on, turned it over, put the feet down more often. Watch Air Force come with a late surge. Three teams within about 2/10.
Air Force did get up for second place by 1/100th over UT Arlington. Wiley wins it 307-15. That was a very competitive.